Have you ever heard about the latest researches about a substance, or let's say a nutrient, that called taurine? Many people said that it can boost your longevity, reduce your aging, and boost your performance, even sexual performance. Let's dive into it in a second. Hi Healthy Peeps, welcome back to our lovely channel, Triple H, How to be Happy and Healthy. And I'm Dr. Hans, the nutritionist and working in functional medicine. Now I'm gonna tell you about the latest researches about a substance. It's called taurine. And what I'm gonna talk today is about the anti-aging secret that's involved in a taurine that many people talk about it now. So before we dive into the benefit, or maybe is it like an overclaim, maybe it's not as good as many people said, now I'm gonna share you about what is taurine, because it's really important. Rather than you will think that it's like a magic pills secret that many people really hard to get into it. So actually, taurine is first the most abundant intracellular amino acid in the body. So actually we have the three groups of amino acid. As you know, the first one is an essential amino acid, the amino acid that you can only get it from food or supplement. The second group is non-essential amino acid, which is our body can produce it well, as long as you got the cofactor or maybe the source. And number three is the conditional amino acid. So taurine is classified as the conditional amino acid, which our body actually can make it, but you need more things to create it. We'll talk about it later. The second thing, taurine is the most abundant free amino acid in the testes. So actually when we talk about a male reproduction, it's really related, and we're gonna talk about it later. And number three, taurine is the second most abundant amino acid in the CNS, which is central nervous system, after glutamine. So if we take a look, this three definition of taurine, you know that taurine, we can get it actually from the source. Either it's endogenous or exogenous. Endogenous means that our body can produce it, as I told you before, which is it's produced in our liver by some cofactors, which is cysteine, niacin, iron, pyridoxine, molybdenum, and etc. So it means if you don't have these nutrients like a cysteine and etc., you can produce it well. So that's why it's classified as conditional amino acid. You need some substances or another cofactors to create it in your body. But you can also get it exogenous, because you can get it from food. What food? Well, it's abundant. Abundant is quite much. Not as much as you think maybe, but it's available in a red meat, in a fish, turkey, or even organ meat, a chicken liver, a chicken kidney, and etc. Then you can also get it from supplement. The supplement, there are some types of supplement, whole-based supplement, then another a synthetic supplement. So just make sure that you get from the whole-based food supplement. Then let's talk about the latest researches about taurine. So actually, before we get into the benefit, what's the impact in our body, there are many research about taurine, but for now, it's still the most research is on mice or rat, then monkeys, and also now it's get into Homo sapiens. What is Homo sapiens? Yes, it's us, it's humans. So what is the impact on our metabolism? The first thing that I'm gonna tell you, it impacts on our fat metabolism, which taurine has been studied that it can increase lipolysis. What is it? Lipolysis, the simple words, is like an increased fat burning. The second thing, it can reduce the glycolytic. So it means because our body has two main fuel. The first is lipid, which turn into ketones. And the second thing is about the glucose. So when you reduce the glycolytic, it means your body use your lipid, use your fat more for the your main fuel. And that's what many people looking for, right? The second thing, it can reduce your blood glucose and reduce your insulin and reduce your triglycerides, which three of them are the metabolic markers in many kind of dyslipidemia or many kinds of metabolic syndrome, which is like a, let's say it's a good benefit for you. The second thing is like the effect, the metabolism on the inflammation in general. So there are like acute inflammation, chronic inflammation, but like overall, it can prevent vascular permeability, especially for you that do exercise. Then it can attenuate the excessive inflammation, like if you're doing exercise, like intense exercise or maybe vigorous exercise, it can help you to speed up your recovery. And it can also inhibit your oxidative stress. Still talking about the exercise, the most benefits that you can get, at least for now, by the researchers, is about the performance, because it can spike or maybe it can like a boost your muscle contraction through the calcium channel, because it can like really involves in a calcium channel absorption. Then it can also decrease your superoxide radical, just name it like a free radical, and it can also help you to repair your muscle damage after exercise. So it can like reduce the lactic acid and stuff like a protein kinase. So it can like help you to repair your muscle damage more. How about the cardiovascular? Well, it also have a good benefits, good impacts on your cardiovascular by far, because taurine has been studied that it can lower your blood pressure. Especially the study has been like happen in a patient who has like a hypertensive or maybe like a pre-hypertensive condition. It can also improve the vascular function by improving the blood flow. It can also improve your hydration because it role as an osmolyte in your body. Then the next benefit is about your cognitive function. Yes, your cognitive function or cognitive health, because the most benefit it plays in your neurogenesis. What is neurogenesis? Neurogenesis is like making the neural stem cell proliferation in your brain. Maybe many people like have been studied about BDNF. Yes, it's like a brain-derived neurotrophic factor. That it's like the new stem cell or maybe the new synapses in your brain that create a new way when you have like a blockage from a stroke event or maybe like a TIA, transient ischemic attack. So it can also works in a neuroinflammation, which means it can reduce cytokines in your brain, the pro-inflammatory markers. Then it can also elevating your NADH or NAD, which is maybe like now there are many studies about like how to boost your NAD. Like maybe I can quote like one of the best scientists ever, Professor David Sinclair, that has been like up the NAD benefits, like for our longevity genes. There are many studies now, and eventually this one taurine, it can also elevating your NAD level. Then last but not least, it can also have benefit, good impact to your reproductive system, especially on male, because it can promote hypothalamus pituitary testosterone axis function. It can also related plays a good impact on the spermatogenesis and also the maturation of the sperm. Then it can also have a protective agent against toxic damage that can come like from a drugs or maybe from your environment or maybe even your food if you often eat junk food. So like why many people take it, like how important to take taurine after you heard like all the benefit that I told you? Because like anybody need to take this taurine to get all of this benefit. Well, actually, it depends on your lifestyle, but so far, like based on study, our blood taurine serum is reduced by age, especially after you touch like 50, at least you will decrease your blood taurine serum about a half. Then another thing, if you like take like a supplement, like a beta-alanine, it will reduce your blood serum taurine as well. Then if you take like a drug or maybe you have like a sedentary lifestyle, you rarely get exercise, you eat junk food, you get like a bad environment, toxic environment, like a herbicide, glyphosate, and etc. Just name it. Now, there are many toxic environments. It can also reduce your blood taurine serum in your body. So blood taurine serum is like related to many things like a longevity, because what I told you, it related to our metabolism, which is our metabolism is also related to our health span. So that's why many people said that this taurine consumption, which is like the benefit got it from supplementation so far in many studies, it can boost your health span and also your lifespan, and also your stem cell production, especially your brain stem cell. So last but not least, so if you want to take the taurine as a supplement, or maybe you can boost it from your food if you want, how much the dosage that effective for you? And is there any side effect that you need to aware of? Well, let's talk about the side effect that the possible side effect that you can get if you take like in a high dosage, or maybe you are allergic, you are like intolerance with the taurine. The side effects over that available is about the lethargy, especially if you consume it on a daytime. Why? Because it can increase the GABA production, which is it is like the inhibitory neurotransmitter that can make you feel like more relaxed, reduce your anxiety. Then if you consume it alongside with like a stimulant like a caffeine, because it can like overwhelm your nervous system and it can make you lethargic, just like if you drink coffee too much. The second thing, the possible side effect that will come is about like the hypotension or lower blood pressure, but not only low, but drop. So far, the studies, it studied about like the blood pressure in the post-hypertensive or pre-hypertensive. So I don't think that it can like make you drop your blood pressure if you are normal, if you have normal blood pressure, but who knows? Somebody can feel it, can experience it if you are like allergic or maybe like you have like a sensitivity in taurine. And the dosage for taurine that as effective as you got from the benefit that I mentioned it before is about 1-3 grams per day. But if you want to start it from like the smaller dosage, like 500 milligrams, just go ahead and just try it. And the best consume it is in the evening, like if you want to like get the anti-anxiety in your nighttime, like you want to like sleep better, it can improve your sleep better, you get the GABA effect when you take it in the evening. Well, overall I think like I have like a sum up all the things that I can get it for now, because the study is still like ongoing, so I think we will get it about the positive effects soon as possible. Thank you. I'm Dr. Hans. Stay fit and stay healthy.